I'm here to share my testimony today. I got married in the month of May 2017, and 2 months down the lane, I fell sick. I didn't know what was happening. I was down, I couldn't get up from where I was seated. I was falling every time wherever I go. I couldn't climb stairs. I couldn't lift my hand. So there were things like this every day. So each day was a new challenge, and I didn't know what I was going through. I started visiting doctors, and I don't know how many doctors I have visited, and none of them knew what I'm going through or what was wrong with me. There was a time where I couldn't stay in my in-laws' house anymore. I had to move down to my mother's place in just 2 months of my marriage. I started visiting more doctors, more appointments, and none of them knew what was wrong with me because they had no clue what it was. There was this one doctor, when I went with my husband, he told me, "My dear, this is not going to happen anymore. And this is something called muscle autotrophy, and you can't survive any longer. I'm not sure how long you would survive. And I think you cannot live a normal life as like any one of us can do." So that day I was shattered. It was devastating for me. I thought I cannot live anymore, and I have nothing to do in my life anymore. At this stage, I told my husband, "Please leave me. Please find a life for yourself. It's not late. Please find a new life for yourself, because I'm not going to be a part of your life anymore." So I stayed back in my mother's place, more and more doctors again. And finally, I landed in Nimans, where I had a biopsy done in my thigh, and they had taken my muscle and given a test, and they found it to be something called dermatomyositis. It's a rare medical condition in India. It affects your muscles completely and your skin. For a certain cause, I didn't have anything in my skin in the beginning, and that was why doctors couldn't figure out what was wrong with me. So I had nothing in my skin. My skin was as good as gold. So, but my muscles started deteriorating. I couldn't do anything. I can't lift my hand. I can't eat my own food. I can't climb stairs. So there was weeks in the hospital, and it took months to figure out what I was going through. And then as time passed on, my health was even more bad. And there was a stage when I was down to a wheelchair, completely lost, completely like a vegetable. I couldn't do anything. So all my muscles started weakening, and my neck muscles were completely weak, so my neck fell. So I can't lift my head up and look at anybody. My back muscles were gone, so if you make me sit, I would just fall off any side. I can't get up, I can't stand, I can't walk. So in a later stage, my throat muscles were affected, where I couldn't chew food and swallow it. I couldn't raise my voice and talk much. And then the skin also started deteriorating. I had a rash, and there was times when there would be mosquitoes biting me, and I just can't even shoo them away. I have to call my mother. That was my state. So I lost completely hope. I said every morning, the first thing that I would say to my mom is, "Why should I even live? Why do I live? Can you just do something to me? Please don't keep me." That was the only thing I used to say. Every day people keep giving me hope. There were pastors coming every day praying for me, saying, "You would be fine someday," but I had no hope. I used to question God, saying, "God, why are you even keeping me? Why should I even be there like this in such a stage? When I've lost my life, I've lost my job, I've lost my marriage, I've lost everything that I wanted for. Why should I even be there?" There were people who kept giving me hope. And one day, I went through this chapter of Job, and I started reading Job completely, time and again. And I could see the strength that he gained when God took away everything from Job. And he had nothing. He said, "Lord, why am I there?" And that was my condition. So I thought, when God could restore Job's life, in double the portion that he had lost. Why not me? I had some hope somewhere, and then I just kept quiet. There were days I didn't talk to anybody. I would never like to see anybody at home except my mother. But I kept saying that there's something that God wants to do in my life. And today, here I stand as a testimony in front of all of you guys. And that God has brought me here through all the struggle to stand here as a living testimony. So I got my answer as to why should I live? And I got my answer saying, you need to live because you would stand someday as a testimony to hundreds of people. So right from a wheelchair where I couldn't walk, I couldn't get up. It took months, it took year, it took almost 12 months in a wheelchair. And then I could slowly stand, I could slowly lift my head, I could slowly talk. And one after the other, in every phase, God has lived with me. He has stood by my side, and I say praise God. And there are times where I couldn't pay my medical bills, and God stood with me even there. So every steroid that I take would be cost me about 50,000 bucks for one injection. There was a time where I had to take an injection and I had no money. But when my mother went and bought the injection, the person in the store said, ma'am, this is free, you don't have to pay. We had no clue why. Because each injection that I take is 50,000 rupees, and why is he saying you don't have to pay? But then he said, no ma'am, you've taken already two injections, so there is some new offer saying this one is free. I've never seen such an offer in a medicine. That was God's work completely. And he's brought me here today, and to many people around, wherever I go, they say, how do you even come back? There are people who thought I would never be back. There are people who thought I would lose my life forever. But God has blessed me double in terms of my job. I'm working today in a better place than that I was before. I'm blessed. I'm walking, I'm running. I can climb three stairs every day, that where my house is now. I climb three floors every day. My muscle strength is back, and the doctors are like, they don't know how I recovered so soon, which is not the case. And this is not a case at all that they've ever seen. And I would say praise God.